Hi friends, today let us see what is a relation between DTFT and DFT. So we will find the relation between DTFT and DFT. So let us start by definition. By definition of DTFT, x of omega or x of e raised to j omega, you can write also, x of omega equals to summation n going from 0 to infinity, doesn't matter if it goes from minus infinity, x of n e raised to minus j omega n. This is my definition of DTFT. If I draw the omega plane or the DTFT plane, it looks like a circle. That circle have a very special radius r equals to 1. And the omega is going continuously on this circle, which is 0 to 2 pi. Now, let us take by definition of DFT. So, it writes as x of k, which is equal to summation n going from 0 to n minus 1, x of n e raised to minus j 2 pi n k by capital N. Now, looking at the two equation itself, I can say that x of n is same as that of x of n. N going from 0 to n minus 1, n going from 0 to infinity, that is summation is also on n. We will see why there is a restriction on n over here and not over here. X of n is the same. And e raised to minus j omega n and e raised to minus something. So, if I equate these two things, in that n is in this and n in this power is also the same. So, what remains is the omega. So, if I see, I drag out omega from here, what comes out from here is 2 pi k by n. That things 2 pi k by n is equivalent or equal to omega, if I put, then I will get this same thing as what DFT gives, right? Provided my n should be restricted to n minus 1, not infinity, okay? Now, what I did is, I have omega going from 2 pi k by n. Now, previously we were knowing that omega is having 2 pi radians of a circle, so 2 pi is there with me. What is this k by n? Okay, so let us determine that. For that, let us draw a circle. So, draw a bigger circle. Now, this circle will go from here to here if I move like this. This is my 2 pi. Complete one circle. If I go like this, come around about over here, it is 2 pi. Now, I chop up this circle into smaller sections. Suppose I chop up it into 8 equal parts. One part I keep over here, second part I keep over here, third part I keep over here, fourth part over here, fifth over here, sixth over here, seven. Okay, so I have actually chopped up 8 equal parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 equal parts. It's like a pizza broken into 8 equal parts. So I have broken, given pizza into 8 equal triangles. And I ask a question, what is this angle now of each sector? Obviously, it will come as the total is 2 pi and I have divided into 8 equal parts. So, it will be 2 pi by 8. That is, each section will be of pi by 4, right? Now, with respect to x axis, what will be this? You will say, of course, it will be pi by 2, or I can say it is 2 pi by 4. Then I go here, it will be 3 pi by 4. I go here, it will be 4 pi by 4 and so on, right? So each section is of pi by 4, each angle, and every angle will be having a multiplier or the value. For example, if I write like this, this is my 0th point, my first point, this is my second point, this is my third point, fourth point, fifth point, sixth point, and seventh point. Because I started from 0, my ending value will be 7. So if I will write like this, 0 pi by 8 is my first angle, no harm. Then I write 1 pi by 8, 1, 2 pi by 8, 0, 2 pi by 8, 1, 2 pi by 8. Then I can write 2, 2 pi by 8. Then I can write 3, 2 pi by 8, and so on. This 2 pi by 8 resembles my pi by 4. Okay. Either I can write like this, 0 pi by 4, 1 pi by 4, 2 pi by 4, 3 pi by 4, and so on till 7 pi by 4. Or this same pi by 4, I can write as 0, 2 pi by 8. Right. So now if you compare this 2 pi by 8, this capital N is actually the number of divisions. In our case, it was 8. Then this integers, that is 2, 3, 4, and so on, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on, is the K. So what I did, I took omega domain, I chopped it up into equal number of parts, and that omega now gives me a new value, which we called as 2 pi K by N. So if I sample or discretize the frequency domain, then I am going to get a DFT. In DTFT, the frequency domain is continuous. In DFT, the frequency domain is discrete. Here I move on a circle continuously, but here we jump on a circle. We don't move, but we jump, because now I have 0th point and then I will have 1 point. I will not have anything in between. Then from 1, I will directly jump to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, and 6 to 7. And after 7, I will go back to 0. So if I say that my K value will go from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and when I go to 8, it is actually nothing but 0. So K is restricted from 0 to 7. What was my N? N was 8, and I jumped till 7. So my K value goes from 0 to N minus 1 and not to N. Whereas how many parts can I make? It is N parts. So I have your variable called capital N. So if I chop up a frequency response or sample a frequency response, or a sampling of a omega domain gives you DFT. So DFT is frequency sampled version of DTFT. So that is a basic relation between DTFT and DFT, that DTFT omega is continuous, DFT omega is discrete, and the limits is 0 to N minus 1. Thank you.